Oh my. Good evening, folks. It's Diamond with Magnetic Reversal News, Grand Solar Minimum Preparedness. We've been shut down over at the Oppenheimer Ranch Project. Have you heard? Well, we're bringing you an update tonight. Thursday, April 11th at midnight, Mountain Time. Simply because our channel was demonetized. Now, it may be my fault. But before I get to that, the next 3 days are looking like a haze in the upper Midwest. We're talking record blizzard conditions, and we'll get to that shortly. But for those of you that are wondering, our monetization of the entire channel, all 1,049 videos, gone. Now, when I started the channel, I put up lots of movies and talks from other sources. And I cited them below. But because of the vague requirements by YouTube, they can shut your channel down for any reason. And according to them, my channel was demonetized completely because of reused content. I reused audiovisual works like TV shows and movies. I reused sound recordings and musical compositions. I reused visual and written works, including paintings, posters, articles, and books. All true. I used dramatic works such as plays and musicals. I am one. And video games and computer softwares do not comply. Now, what I think they mean is that I have a bunch of movies up and other things which I've taken down. Anything that is not original content that I created, I've removed. I removed over 50 videos at this point. And I'm going to continue to do it all month until May 9th when I'm going to reapply for monetization. Who knows what will happen then? But in the meantime, we have this channel which is still up and running. Magnetic Reversal News, Grand Solar Minimum Preparedness. You're in the right place, folks. And I thank you for being here. Historic blizzard may drop up to 2 feet of snow across central U.S., cause life-threatening travel conditions. We're talking life-threatening conditions mid-April across the U.S. Aberdeen, Sioux Falls, Minneapolis, Marquette, North Platte, heads up. Up to 2 feet of snow is possible in some spots across the central U.S. from this major storm system. Now, a swath of 1 to 2 feet of snow is forecast in the Central Plains, where there's 6 states under blizzard warnings as we speak. The highest amounts of snow is expected to blow the minds of all of Al Gore's supporters across South Dakota, but the combination of snow and strong winds throughout the region will make traffic absolutely impossible. Not only that, schmossible. Which means that you're going to kill yourself if you go out. So if you live in South Dakota, stay home in this red zone right now. And tomorrow, if you're in Minnesota in the Southwest, stay home. I don't care if they make you come to work. Do you really need to die for $100? Come on. A significant late season hashtag winter storm will impact a large portion of the country from Wyoming to Colorado through the Great Lakes. Up to 2 feet of snow hashtag will be actual snow. Impacting you and making for life-threatening conditions into your April. For many of you, it was just 70 degrees. And now it's boom time. So please heed the warnings as we warn. Blizzard warnings issued across central U.S. as region faces boom cyclone. Shut up, Al. Get your hole. Now, this cyclone is a ham bone. right in your side. A storm impacting the Rockies and Plains currently has met the scientific definition of what is commonly known as a bomb cyclone. More than that, it has met the definition of blizzard in six states in the upper Midwest. It's the second such blast to hit the region in less than a month. Hundreds of flights have been canceled, even though Punxsutawney Phil told us that some roads in the region would not become impassable and accidents haven't already occurred. Someone should take that groundhog to jail. Blizzard warnings are posted throughout the region, and we're going to get to the models in a second if you bear with us. Here are live I-29, I-90 shutdown as major storm whips central U.S. and whiteout conditions and high winds pummel the region. A major spring storm is bringing heavy thundersnow. Ho, ho, ho. Let's watch that again. Let's watch this thundersnow and do a dab for me. Dab it up. Awesome footage. Thunder snow rumbles in South Dakota. Say it ain't soda. There are seals. They are seals. Hold on to your horses. A major spring storm is bringing heavy snowfall, high winds, and whiteout conditions across a large swath of the central U.S. Impacts are expected to last through Friday. They got it wrong. We'll show you the models. The powerful storm hit South Dakota the hardest on Wednesday as snowfall quickly piled up following an early morning occurrence of thundersnow, which we just showed you. By mid-morning on Wednesday, Mud Butte, South Dakota had reported 18 inches of the global warming goodness. In nearby Red Elm, 15 inches of snowfall had been reported. And they got shorted by 3 from the big people. But high winds there reportedly causing snowdrifts of 4 to 5 feet, which could bury Al Gore while he was on his knees. AccuWeather forecasters said up to 30 inches of snow could fall in some areas. Which is scary as, because it's mid-April. Which is not lining up to be boom time, but it is knowledge time. And what that means is we need you to prepare. This is going to continue to ramp up for the rest of your lives. Historic springtime snowstorm wallops the Rockies, north central U.S. as it intensifies, and we will continue to get demonetized to bring you the facts.
It's been making for a messy situation in the Dakotas. You can see the video from Wednesday in Watertown, South Dakota. Not just snow, but also a lot of wind, and that's going to be one of the components with this storm as we continue on into your Thursday. Some of the top snowfall reports coming in from South Dakota. You can see one location, 18 inches of snow, and we're going to be seeing way more than that as we head into Thursday here. But it's not just all about the snow. There will be some areas that see a bit of a mix, and then as you get farther east, there will be some rain. And also the threat for severe weather as well. But I want to mention the snowy part of things here. This is where we anticipate the true worst conditions, the true blizzard conditions, if you will, where we could see gusts as high as 45 to 55 miles per hour. And not just that, visibility less than a quarter of a mile or so. So travel is going to be significantly impacted as we continue into Thursday.
I apologize. I increased the resolution so you could all do a dab.
Thursday night and for some areas right into Friday as well. So here's a look at the latest AccuWeather snowfall map, a large area that we have outlined in white for you. That's 12 to 24 inches of snow, but the AccuWeather local storm max is as high as 30 inches. So there could be a couple of spots that pick up over 2 to even close to 3 feet of snow. We'll see if we get there. But again, it's not just going to be the snow. It's also going to be quite windy. And then we'll have to watch out for some of these severe thunderstorms to fire their way on east as we get into Thursday afternoon.
Oh my God, I hope you bared with me. There are the facts, straight from the media. Snow is coming down fast and furious in the Rockies in north central U.S. and expected to accumulate over 30 inches in some pockets. Meanwhile, under lightning accompanied in the intense snowfall in some areas on Wednesday. Can you say thunder snow? Ho, ho, ho. Yeah. Yeah, Christmas was 4 months ago. The storm blasted parts of the West with heavy rain, heavy mountain snow, power-cutting winds, and blowing dust into Tuesday into Wednesday. The early stages of the storm knocked out power to 50,000 in L.A., knocked up dramatic dust in Nevada, which is not a shmata. Holy hada, there's a podcast. It's already a massive storm and will continue to grow. And if we were to just hit right click, new tab, and go to Power Outage US. Oh my God, it's not even gonna let us do it. P-O-W-E-R. Yeah, did you see Pornhub in there? That was amazing. Apparently I've been there, or someone on this computer. PowerOutage.us. This is a resource that everyone needs, including Pornhub. But welcome. And if you go to PowerOutage.us, it will load the map and it will show you the storm that stretches across the country. A total of 200 million people in the U.S. That's just a few people will feel the impacts of this intense weather system called the bomb cyclone. And what that means is that your power goes out and we can follow it live. So we can see here that there are 10 million customers tracked and 10,000 out. So we still have that minor outage, but we were going to be looking in the morning. If you come to Power Outage US and you're wondering what's going on, the upper Midwest is going to be experiencing severe power outages. And here we see Minnesota kicking up right now with 5,000, South Dakota with 3,200, Michigan with 2,300. These numbers will soar in the next 24 hours. If you want to know how to click on it and to see who else is suffering in your region, go to Power Outage US and get prepared for the times that are coming. You have to know how to do this research yourself. I will be off the air and you need to survive and thrive yourselves. Denver travel mass, 750 flight cancellations and counting. Now, thank God I didn't have LeeCon in February. Yeah, it's in May. It's going to be glorious. Blizzard warnings are posted from Colorado to Minnesota on Wednesday. And wildfires were a concern in New Mexico. Red flag warnings everywhere. I'm going to show you the weather.gov map, and it's going to blow your mind. Airlines canceled more than 750 flights in and out of Denver Wednesday ahead of the spring blizzard. Winter storm watch. And the travel pain is expected to spread to other cities as this potentially historic storm moves into the upper Midwest, which is not the best right now. It is the flight cancellation central. Now, let's walk you through the GFS and show you the destruction. We already reported on up to 1.5 feet of snow in South Dakota, and these are the new models, which is going to show another foot or more in South Dakota, which is going to bring them way above 3 feet. Here's your 48-hour outlook. We're talking 32 to 36 inches in eastern Minnesota. South Dakota is going to be pummeled. The entire eastern section of the state is going to be buried under 1.5 feet of snow on top of the already 1.5 feet of snow that's already there. Northern Nebraska has a huge swath of 16 plus. Iowa, you've missed the bullet. Yeah, but Wisconsin is in on the fun. Central Mich is picking up some heavy dumps of 6 to 10. So it's not like that. And then there'll be lake effect snow moving to the east as this beast buries the upper Midwest. We have secondary systems throughout April, which are going to bring an eastern storm, which has snow plodding all the way to Georgia. Did you ever see snow in Georgia pulling up here on April 20th? Heads up, Puxatony Phil is a liar, and Magnetic Reversal News is on fire. Because Magnetic Reversal News is run by the Oppenheimer Ranch Project, We are members of the Weather Ready Nation service. We are Weather Ready Nation ambassadors, and we'll bring you the news as it comes out from the main source, the National Weather Service. Major storm system to continue widespread hazardous weather across much of the central U.S. into Friday. Whew. Holy lie day, if they meant global warming. A major spring storm will continue to... with heavy snow and blizzard conditions from the Dakotas to the Minnesota, say it ain't sodas, Thursday into Friday, further south, destructive winds, blowing dust, critical fire weather continues for the southern plains, severe thunderstorms will threaten the eastern Illinois region and western Indiana. Heads up, James Crouch, we're about to show you the total precipitated water over the next 7 days, and it's looking like flooding nightmare in Indiana, power outages, dangerous travel is likely due to this hazardous blizzard conditions in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Schleville, Schlevazel. We're gonna have a blizzard right before summer. Yeah. Heavy winds throughout central Texas, southern Arizona, say it ain't Sona, and winter storm watches and warnings, including blizzard warnings and watches in 13 states on the 11th of April. Winter storm watches and warnings, blizzard warnings and watches in 6 states, winter storm watches and warnings in 13 states on the 11th of April. You're watching Magnetic Reversal News, Grand Solar Minimum Preparedness, because it's the only news you need to know. GFS total accumulated precipitation shows that Northern Indiana will receive 8 to 12 inches of precipitated moisture in the next 7 days. Now, thankfully, big numbers are not showing up here in Northern California where the Oroville complex is, and it is getting higher by the moment. But this bodes very poorly for the Mississippi River Valley, the upper Midwest, the upper plains. There's going to be heavy losses, flooded homes, as the Mississippi bulges down through Arkansas and Louisiana in the coming weeks, it will be a flood nightmare. Coming soon, if you live in these regions where this amount of rain is falling, heads up. Better get a new sump pump for your basement, which wouldn't be a waste of money. It would actually be quite practical. Now I'm going to take you over here to weather.gov to show you the situation we are now currently existing in. And then you can see after that amount of rain falls, how bad it will get. So let this parse up a minute. Maybe we can talk about something else, like parsing up some more things. So let's come to the flood map. It's going to load itself slowly. So, what we can see here is that there's 500 rivers near flood stage or at major flood. 500 rivers, and they're all down here in the Mississippi corridor. And the major water is going to fall over here just to the east of these purple major flooding gauges, which is going to add insult to injury. I'm going to leave you links to this. You just click on your river or your square and you get the information of that river. This way you can save your lives and plan the time to get out, etc. But what's going to happen in the coming days and weeks is this entire region, the upper Midwest and Midwest, is going to light up in purple, red, and orange. We're talking near flood stage, minor flooding, moderate, and major flooding. And if you want to know how to survive and thrive in the future, you have to know how to use these maps. So I'm going to leave you links below. This is how you zoom. You can zoom in on your state. Just click on the river or the drainage system in your region. And if you have satellite, it'll totally suck. But if you have cable, oh, God, you're golden. Like Colorado. Let's try to move this over here. We can't even do that. All right, I showed you how to do it, and we're 20 minutes in. You're up on course for glacial battering in the middle of April. Now, we haven't reported on the UK for almost 8 weeks. And that's because the major snow in the Alpine region has fallen. And it is epic. It is one of the top snow seasons for decades in that region. But it's not over. And I knew it wasn't over. And here's the proof. A frigid Scandinavian cold front is plunging into the UK and much of the mainland Europe as I speak, driving temperatures well below zero and bringing harsh, damaging frost to delicate spring crops. Now, this is very bad. And we're going to get to that really quick. Oh, look at all of Germany. Oh my goodness. And all of the UK. And this is coming from Electroverse. Thanks, Cap, Alon. WX charts reveal temperatures will drop to a nipple hardening. Holy macaroni, minus 7°C in many parts of the UK this weekend. That's a nipple hardening temperature, if I've ever seen one. And look at the graphs, they're very blue. And I'm sure bookies in the UK have slashed odds, this April being the coldest on record. Carl has a 5-4 chance of it snowing in any major city over the Easter weekend with odds of 11-8 on it being the coldest April ever. And look at the ice building in Greenland. Holy schmeinland. Way above baseline. This is a 30-year mean and it's above the gray. All right, we're just getting to that. We'll get the space wet. We'll get the space news now. Wavy jet stream. Spring surprise. Yes, the cherry blossoms are frozen. Snow falls in Kanto region with more forecast Thursday. Tokyo, parts of the Kanto region were plunged into a snowy midwinter condition on April 10th due to a combination of unseasonably cold air and low atmospheric pressure. Not only that, Diamond's predictions as well. So, no cherries in China. At 8 a.m. on April 10th, temperatures in Tokyo city center were as low as 6°C. Snowfall of 2 to 3 centimeters were observed north of the capital in Nikko, Tojiki Prefecture, and to the west of Tokyo in Fukuoka Chukuchiko and Yashishimi Prefecture. Snow was also recorded in the city of Ome in the west of the capital. According to the Japanese Meteorological Agency, temperatures on April 10th are forecast to reach a high of 7. It's like if you live in heaven in eastern Japan, temperatures are expected to hit a high of 5 in Santa Mama and Utsunomiya, and just 4 degrees in Maebashi, where they'll be making sushi. Like, it's kind of like sushi, but with snow. It's like a ho, ho, ho. Here's the 1,000-year sunspot model update to April 2018 with the new sunspot numbers, according to Zarkova and others. Using the double dynamo linear progression and magnetic and mathematical modeling, they've come up with quite a high resolution with a 5% probability of it being wrong. That means it's 95% correct. And if you didn't know, 99.5% of all solar scientists were wrong in predicting solar cycle 24. There were only two that were correct, and Valentina Zarkova was one of the two people. Yes. So who would you believe for the prediction? Them or her? Well, if you want to take it for a grain of salt, the mainstream has now, that was coming off of a 4-year period of predicting solar cycle 25 to be higher than 24, they just now came out 3 days ago and saying it's going to be the same or less. Do you see how they're hedging the bets? It was going to be bigger, like this one, but now it's the same or less because Zarkova said it's going to be non-existent. And then there's going to be a 5-year period of complete solar shutdown from 2028 to 2033, where crop production worldwide will cease to exist. Yeah, that's in 9 years. That spot. I think I would want to be ready before then. Because you know what happens here? The grid starts to fail in 2024. And if Doug Vogt is right, here in 2026, right here at the peak, the sun will explode. when the magnetic reversal occurs. You know what happens then? Boom time. Seismic update, no quakes of note. Moderate uptick worldwide. Interesting quakes coming out of New York yesterday. I'm sure the fear mongers up in Yellowstone are telling everyone they're all going to die. This is normal activity in Montana. Strange activity in Ferron, Utah, though. And here we have a 5.1 in Mohina, India, followed by an aftershock. And we've showed you some data that suggests just north of here, a major 7 or 8 magnitude will occur in the near future. Just north of here. It could be today. It could be next month. It will occur. Any questions, leave them below. Worldwide volcano news update. Fuego blowing today. Major outbursts. Volcanoes worldwide. Santa Guito, Fuego Popo, Bromo, Chivalush. Check out Chivalush blowing at 34,000 feet and 33,000 feet, respectively. I think I have a video live stream of Chivalush up. I don't. Let's real quick get to that. So we can just go over to Kvart and get the live stream for you kids and see if it's still light there. Crossing my fingers. Boom! Still activity on the summit crater. This is a live shot over at Chevalouche in the Kamchatka. You know why? Because we can do that for you. How do you feel? Special. We're coming over here to Popocatapetl to show you the exhalaciones and the volcano tectonicos and the explosion and the tremor. But you can clearly see an uptick in exhalaciones and also a major uptick 10th of April in volcano tectonicos. What does that mean for you? Well, it either means you need to take Spanish or Popo did a boom boom. And it needs to wipe its pants. Holy macaroni. I was right. Look at the collapse in the caldera there. Indicative of a large eruption coming. You remember Kilauea? Yes. Look at that hole. Would you look at it? Just look at that hole. Do a dab. I'll be right back. Well, we're back. This shit isn't even loaded. So we're just gonna bag it. Links will be below. solarham.net/index.htm. Now, we are at solar minimum, cycle 24. We're at the bottom. We're waiting for the solar polar magnetic fields to flip anytime now, which will kick off a major earthquake. We'll know when it happens. The whole earth will rumble. But I want you to check out sunspot 2738, black hole sun. Won't you come? Apparently you don't want to load. Sunspot 2738, beta CHO, C flares 15%, M at 1%, X at 1%. I got no photos. But you can see it's a big, bad mamma jamma, which is not that bad at all. There's very little magnetic mixing. And what we can see here is the red line back on April 9th as this baby turned around the limb, dropping lower and lower and lower. That's indicative of what happens during solar minimum. These sunspots get shut down as they turn towards the Earth. So we are experiencing normal solar minimum activity here as the sunspot gets shut down. It could still flare up into C, potentially M, as it faces Earth the next few days, but we'll watch it. So far, it's showing a calming, not a rising. But anything can happen. Phi angle is still pretty safe. We're worried when it comes down to 180. Density falling off. Plasma wind speed right at 420. Perfect. As usual. Chivalouche. There it is. Still puffing. Still passing. E. coli outbreak in Kentucky, Ohio, and other states sickened 100, and you're fluxed. This is just one of, there's measles in New York and out here on the West Coast, and diseases are rampant. We've predicted this a year ago, that there will be outbreaks and quarantines and Ebola, and air temperatures in the Arctic are driving the system change. This came out 2 days ago. A new paper showing that air temperatures are the smoking gun behind climate change in the Arctic. Yeah. Thanks. Links below. Now, it's the big day, kids. Here's the picture of the black hole. There it is. Now, I'm not even going to read the article. Let's just talk about the picture. This is not a black hole. Period. A black hole is a mathematical fantasy constructed by many mathematicians, accepted by astrophysicists, and disseminated on the zombified mainstream, who not only teach it in the schools, but everyone believes it. All ages. Black holes, dark matter, blippity blappity blue. But this is a pretty and bright black hole. Now, what I'm going to do real quick is break it down for you, all the way down to the donut. And I have a video here of some of the dumbest scientists on the planet, and I'll just share you a minute of it.
And yet they contain so much information about the physics of the universe.
I've been dreaming about this for 25 years.
When I saw the first data,
it was just some weird plot, and it looked like there could be a ring in there. I was like, oh my God, this is going to be interesting. It looked pretty much what we were expecting.
It's a toroid. It's a Z-pinch, you prick. Do you never heard of the magnetic, the electric universe? How about magnetism?
This is just like kind of the beginning.
Oh my God, I just heard that like there's a Z-pinch and they call it a black hole.
In physics. But already we've learned so much. So, you know, we didn't know, even though we had predicted that if you had a black hole that you would see this ring of light, we didn't know we were going to get that ring of light. And that's, you know, what we were kind of.
Oh my God, that's science right there. They predicted there would be a ring of light, and she's never seen a ring of light before. There has never been a ring of light seen in the universe ever. No one has ever seen a ring of light. Nor have they claimed that this ring of light is a black hole, because they would have been laughed at. So they show us this, and it's a black hole, but they show us that, and it's not a black hole. That's not a black hole. That is. That's not a black hole. That's not a black hole. That's not. That is. Because it's blurry. That's how we know it's a black hole. Once it's cleared up, it's a nebula. it's a star novaing. But this is a black hole. This is a star novaing. This is a black hole, real blurry. I wonder what happens if you blur this out. It probably looks like that. Because it's a toroid. It's a toroidal shape. Maybe it's a donut. Oh my. Yeah. It's a donut. Of course it's a donut. It's a toroid. It's a Z-pinch. Now, you're looking at the donut. It's right there. It's pink. There's no black hole. There's no evidence for this to be a black hole. For them to claim that this is a picture of a black hole is almost as embarrassing as the acronym NASA, who in the last few months we've pretty much proven is a front for investigating the micronova of our sun, beginning with the fraud with Stanley Kubrick and the fake videos taken of the moon landing because they didn't even know they would make it. And then once they got there, the audio tapes that have been recently released about them collecting glass samples on the surface that you never heard about. That is not a black hole. That is disinformation. That is a torus, a toroid that is looking and this particular area was also ejecting a plasma jet just a year ago from the black hole. Not. I don't even understand how science and the kids learning it. I feel so sorry for them. They just suck it up from these frauds. Black hole. Not, it's a Z pinch. Anyone want to argue with me on the channel, please look me up. OppenheimerRanch@gmail.com. You know what's going on and you're a fraud. We predicted it would be a donut and I saw one. It was amazing. It was a glazed donut of black holeness right in my face, like a boom of knowledge. I couldn't believe it. Another study shows that supplements don't work and may kill you. Yeah, this is created by a chemical company in a lab and then produced in a manufacturing plant by a machine. If you grow your own food, you can just eat that every day, right out of the ground. And it won't have pesticides in it like this pill. And it will actually help you because your body knows how to process plants because you've been eating them for a million years. It's certainly not that. Hey, and if you're still prepping and you use margarine, did you know it's just one molecule away from plastic? And it shares 27 ingredients with paint. I'm just trying to butter you up. For the final slide. Wolf, USA. Stop asking questions. Start taking responsibility for your preparedness. Sign up to Wolf, USA, the worldwide organization of organic farms. There are 100,000 of them worldwide. There are 2,115 in the U.S. that you can live at for free, learn how to do what they're doing, and survive and thrive in the future. You don't need a penny. You just need the balls to quit your job and go. Do it now. Three Canyons is listed. You can't even find your farm. Proper prior planning prevents piss poor performance. Chivalouche is blowing to 6.5 miles into the stratosphere. The sunspot model, the winning predictor of last decade, Zarkova, is who I'm going with for the future. Not only that, it's my own personal opinion and my own conclusions before Zarkova came out with her model that we are entering the grand solar minimum in cycle 25 and 26 will deepen ever deeper because we're actually on the cusp of a magnetic reversal and the entering of the next glacial cycle in the 100,000-year cycle. Now, the reason I can say this with clarity is because my background for decades, three decades goes back to the Milankovitch hierarchy of cyclicity, where I studied the 100,000-year, the 20,000-year, and the 400,000-year cycle ad nauseum every day for 7 years. And I've been doing it ever since. And the information is coming clearer. Start preparing now. You have less than a decade until the world changes. And a decade after that, it will be unimaginable. I thank you all for joining us at our new channel. I hope to see many of you at LeeCon. Please share this video on your social media networks so that others can find out about the excellent information at Magnetic Reversal News. And hopefully in May 9th, Oppenheimer Ranch will be remonetized. But in the meantime, we will continue to post over there our practical daytime activities here at the ranch so that you can learn through experience how we fail and we succeed. We love each and every one of you. Thanks to the 11 people that stepped up over the last 24 hours to become new Patreons. I think I thanked each and every one of you personally. If I didn't, I apologize. I meant to. Proper prior planning prevents piss poor performance. It's spring. If you're in the upper Midwest, you can't start preparing unless you have a greenhouse. But anywhere else, I implore you, learn how to fail at growing food. Through this will be the key to your success. Failure is the key to the future. Fail now, survive and thrive later. We love you. Be safe. LeeCon 2019. Links below.